This is me, attempting to do the swivel. And what it's supposed to really look like is this. Yeah, mine looks nothing like that. Hey yo interneters, welcome back to another Penspinning video. And so for today, I'm gonna try and make my swivel actually look like a swivel. And to do that, we kinda gotta know how the swivel is done. And basically, you wanna take your pen and place it down on your fingers like this, and then just bend your fingers down to hold it. Generally, you don't want to hold it past the center of gravity of your pen. For this pen mod, the center of gravity is indicated by this line right here. And so basically from there, I like to hold it on this spot where my pinky is right about halfway from this section right here. And so from there, we will actually turn our wrist like this to actually have the momentum started for the pen. And so if you're doing this motion, it will be one quick motion with your wrist, and then from there the pin should gain momentum and it will come off of your pinky like this, and it will spin on top of your fingers, and you'll just lift up your index finger and have the pin land just like that. And so now that we got the easy part out the way, I guess that takes us back to where we last left off, which is me learning how to do the swivel. But as you remembered, that didn't go too well. And so starting off with the swivel, I was all over the place. I didn't understand how this pin trick worked at all. I didn't understand how the pin is supposed to go from below your pinky to on top of your fingers. I didn't understand the wrist turn because that felt really awkward with my wrist. And then overall, it was really, really horrible. And I didn't even know how to actually get full control of the pin when I was actually practicing this for the very first time, which made it very, very difficult. And yeah. And so the thing about the swivel is that it requires a lot of wrist motion and movement. And sometimes it's a little bit awkward when you're trying to practice and trying to find your that sweet spot of emotion, I guess you could say, to actually get this pin to spin around your thumb. And so when I was practicing the swivel, it actually started putting a lot of strain on my wrist. And because of that, I actually took a lot of frequent breaks. And so a couple of minutes in, I managed to have my first catch, but at the same time I was contemplating whether that was actually me doing the swivel or not. And so fast forwarding about 10 minutes later into the video, I actually thought that I got the swivel down by this point, because I was consistently catching the pin and I was feeling pretty good about myself. I was like, hey, I'm kind of finished, and then I could actually post the video. But in actuality, I didn't learn the swivel, and here's the reason why. And so when we're taking a look at PS Central doing the swivel, the pin actually starts spinning on top of his pinky knuckle area, and then it will spin on top of the rest of his finger into the index. And also, his pin have rotation when he flips it off his pinky, right? And mine didn't do any of this. And so when I was doing the swivel, I would turn my wrist and then the pin will begin to fly above my fingers. And from there, I would just hit this pin with my index finger. Like, I don't even know how I hit it. I hit it something like this, I think. Or like this. I don't even know how to explain it, but I would hit the pin and it will somehow spin, do a spin like mid-air or something, and it would just land like this. And so because of those reasons, I felt like I wasn't doing the swivel, because what I was doing with the pin trick, it didn't match what I saw in the video. I might have been doing the swivel all this time, but it just, I wasn't sure. And so the best thing for me at this point is actually to continue practicing a little bit more, so I can try to make the swivel looks more of what I saw in the video. And plus, it will make the swivel looks nice anyway, so it's a win-win kind of. And so after I rewatched that clip, I was focused on trying to get the spin or the rotation of the pin to begin the moment it leaves my pinky. And I didn't know how to actually do that, and I was practicing on tweaking many different things to try to get that to work. And I stopped worrying about getting the pin on top of my hand, but I focused more on that rotation of the pin more. And so one of the things I changed that was pretty easy to do is the grip, or how I held the pin. So before, I would place it on my palm and I would grip it down like this, but that didn't help me at all. Basically what I ended up doing is I actually placed it on my pinky right here, and I would just bend it down with these two fingers. The index and ring finger, it really didn't grip the pin that much, and basically this was what I did. which helped a lot. And I actually held the pin or support my this tip of the pin with my thumb. And basically from there, this helped with the release of the pin because I'm holding it very light and it would just fly once it catch momentum. Another thing that I did that really helped is the intensity and the speed at which I turned my wrist. And so before I would just turn like this and I would like have this flick on my thing, on my wrist, like flicking up, and the pin would just fly over, which wasn't what I really want. And so what I ended up doing was I actually just turned like all the way around the pin. And then from there, it would just come over. Like, it's just the speed that I adjust at my wrist. And so did doing these tweaks actually help me? To be honest, I really don't know. All I know is when I was doing these tweaks, it actually helped me understand how to actually turn my wrist a little bit more and how fast I should turn it and how sharp I should turn it. In a sense, it actually made my understanding of the pentrick a little bit better and it made it look more smooth. So I'm not sure if these actually would help, but it kind of did for me, I guess you could say. And so as I make these small adjustments and continue to work with them to try to incorporate and make it feel comfortable in my hand, I slowly gain an upward motion, I guess you could say, or upward climb in learning the swivel. And what I mean by that is as time progresses, I slowly get better. There's no moments where I felt stuck, or there's no moment where I felt like I was, instead of learning, I was actually not learning and being in a tougher spot. And so, I really don't know how long I've been practicing this for, or at least I don't have an accurate amount. It's roughly about 4 hours, and the reason why is because I forgot to set the timer, unfortunately. I forgot to actually hit the start button. Other than that, it's roughly about 4 hours. I'm able to actually do the swivel now. And yeah, I'm actually satisfied with the swivel, and hopefully that is the swivel. Maybe, I don't know if it is or isn't, but if it's not, please let me know down in the comments below. That would be pretty embarrassing. Should have done more research before I do this video. I don't know. But anyways, that's pretty much all I have for today. And if you enjoyed the video, please make sure you hit that like and subscribe button. And like always, thanks for watching, and until next time.